Hello.
I'm Rufus Olivier, Jr., bassoonist with the San Francisco Opera, San Francisco Ballet, and formerly San Francisco Symphony for over 40 years. I'm coming to you from an undisclosed location. I call this my bassoon cave. Carl Maria Friedrich Ernst von Weber was a German composer, conductor, pianist, guitarist, and critic, and was one of the first significant composers of the Romantic school. Born November 18, 1786 in Germany, died June 5th, 1826 in London, England. The bassoon concerto was commissioned by bassoonist George Friedrich Brandt. He was a student of George Wenzel Ritter, who was Mozart's favorite bassoon player, by the way. It was written in 1811 from November 14th to the 27th. Brandt premiered it on December 28th, 1811. One of the two bassoon works that Weber wrote, the other being the Andante and Rondo, which was actually written for viola first, but it's also a bassoon piece. So I share a concerto with a viola player. His concerto for bassoon is considered second to Mozart's bassoon concerto, and both are and were used in the playing exams at the Paris Conservatory. Weber was a romantic composer that used classical forms. He often wrote his works backward. In other words, he would start maybe with the third movement, then the second movement, and then the first movement. I think the second movement and the third movement go together very well. The first movement to me seems almost not attached to the piece, but it is a great piece in itself. For that reason, I'm going to just play the second movement and the third movement. Now a little trivia, and I have to get this right. Let's see now. Weber's father's half-brother, which would make that Weber's uncle, or half-uncle if you would call it, he had four daughters. And one of these daughters was pursued by Mozart. Now, it was a one-way pursuit. However, Mozart ended up marrying one of the daughters, Constanza, anyway. And fortunately for him, it was the love of his life, which makes that Mozart married Weber's cousin. Anyway, a little trivia. Now, in his opera, Der Freischütz, Weber not only helped liberate German opera from French and Italian influences, but in his novel orchestrations and in his choice of a subject matter containing strong supernatural elements, he laid the foundations of one of the principal forms of the 19th century opera. Der Freischütz made Weber a national hero. Woohoo! I'm going to quote Weber because it's so beautiful. He said, "What love is to man, music is to the arts and to mankind. Music is love itself. It is the purest, most ethereal language of passion, showing in a thousand ways all the possible changes of color and feeling. And though true in only a single instance, it yet can be understood by thousands of men and women who all feel differently." Wow. Anyway, here is the second and third movement of Weber's bassoon concerto.
Thank
Thank you. You know, at a time like this, when we all have time to reflect and think of our global situation, I'm reminded of a few things. One is that we are all the same. Two, when all else shuts down, it's the arts that keep us going. It shows man, womankind at its best. And if you're looking at this, I think you already know that. Thank you all for your attention and support. Hopefully, we will meet one day. And you know, without this thing, stay safe, people. Wear your mask.